Hey there, South Florida, 2020 is among us. And as we get ready to begin a new year, we'll be taking a closer look at what's happening around town. Let's kick things off in good old February, where you're gonna have to ask yourself a very important question. Are you ready for some football? South Florida is hosting the Super Bowl at Hard Rock Stadium on February 2nd. And you can bet things will be busy around town. Then starting February 15th, the Coconut Grove Arts Festival, an annual three-day outdoor event celebrating fine arts, live performances, and local flavors. NBC6 is a proud sponsor. Next up, the world-famous South Beach Wine and Food Festival, a five-day event showcasing the talents of the world's most renowned wine and spirits producers, chefs, and culinary personalities. Its 19th annual edition taking place February 19th through the 23rd. Heading into March now, and Inter Miami's first ever home match in Major League Soccer. They'll host their famous co-owner David Beckham's old team, the LA Galaxy, on Saturday, March 14th at Inter's temporary new home in Fort Lauderdale. Get ready to jazz it up for the 15th year in a row. Jazz in the Gardens will keep music lovers entertained with some of the best jazz and R&B entertainers. Scheduled for the weekend of March 14th, the event will bring thousands of people to Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens, so be there. And also get ready to exercise your American right during the 2020 presidential primaries on March 17th. That's when voters in the state of Florida will have their say on the Democratic and Republican nominees. Electronic music lovers unite back at Bayfront Park for the Ultra Music Festival. World-renowned DJs taking the stage for a 21st year for a weekend of fast tempo bass and a whole lot of lights. That's March 20 through 22nd. That leads us into April now with the National Census Day. Every 10 years, the government conducts a census to count every resident in the United States. The census is conducted in years ending in zero, and the reference day for the next census will be April 1st, 2020. Sailing right on into South Florida is Virgin Voyages, Richard Branson's Sea Venture, an adults-only cruise ship. The new line advertises no kids, no buffets, and no limits. Based in Miami, the first voyage of the ship named the Scarlet Lady departs April 1st. Puerto Rico, get ready to spice things up as the Marlins head to Puerto Rico to face off against the New York Mets. That's April 28th through 30th. A three-game series in San Juan, marking the fourth trip to the island for the Marlins. That brings us to July and August, a busy time in the world of sports. We're of course talking about, you got it, the 2020 Olympics. Let's take a look. Tokyo, Japan hosting the Olympic Summer Games, July 24th through August 9th, making it the second time the city hosts the Summer Olympic Games. Some new competitions will be launched as well, including 3x3 basketball and freestyle BMX. And of course, you can watch it all unfold right here on The Place, NBC6. And a longer summer? Well, Broward County students might be excited for this one. School is starting 5 days later than usual this year on August 19th. Fast forward to November and a very historic day for our country, Election Day on November 3rd. It'll be our country's 59th presidential election, and the elected will be sworn into office on January 20th, 2021. And more good news for Broward County students. They'll get the entire week of Thanksgiving off, November 23rd through 27th. Still no set calendar for Miami-Dade schools, not just yet anyway. And if it feels like it just happened, it's because it just did. But this time, Art Basel will be celebrating his 50th anniversary starting December 3rd. Hundreds of galleries, thousands of artists from dozens of different countries showcasing works of art in all forms, drawing people from around the globe. 2020 is also a leap year, and it's looking like a good one so far, especially when it comes to holiday celebrations. Halloween is on Saturday, boo-hoo. Christmas is on a Friday, and so is New Year's Day. Hello, long weekend. July 4th lands on a Saturday, Valentine's Day on a Friday, and Cinco de Mayo, cha-cha-cha, lands on a Tuesday, adding on to the Taco Tuesday hype. In the studio, Trina Robinson, NBC 6 News. We'll be right back.